here's the news.
Oh my gosh, indeed, here is the news. And Green Lantern, what are you doing around here? Aren't you supposed to be like saving someone with your little ring that you use?
I'm taking a day off. I'm going to the Poconos.
Okay. Sounds great. I don't think I need these. And welcome to the Hayden Films Minutes Extra Edition. My name is Hayden Krudoff, your host.
And I'm Michaela Grundle, your other host.
All right. Excellent. So thanks for joining us, Diana. It's good to see you.
You too,
because I know you haven't been around for a while. You've been in an invisible jet and whatnot. So before we get started to our great new episode today, please make sure you like, subscribe to the channel. It helps our students out. And if you want to see some of our previous episodes, please click the link above. And now to the topic at hand. We're going to be talking about social media, mm-hmm. and particularly TikTok,
yep.
and consumer attention.
Exactly.
So with that said, you know, looking at TikTok most recently from really a entrepreneurship basis, mm-hmm. it's like, how do we incorporate TikTok in today's world when there's so many other channels, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, right. LinkedIn? So from your perspective, I know you've been doing a lot of research on TikTok, most importantly. What have you found in your research? And I know you have another announcement to make, but I'll just get that because I see we have news that Hal left us. But tell us a little bit about your initial research on TikTok in particular.
Right. So I definitely think that you bring up a good point with other platforms competing with TikTok. But the biggest thing that I've seen with TikTok and its qualities is, you know, video-based content allows for people to consume content in a more immersed way, in a more, you know, personal way. So mm-hmm. they get to know a brand way more. So that's what I've come to realize about TikTok and video-based content.
You know, it's interesting that you said that, but real quick, we want to make sure you guys all know that this episode is being brought to you by
Hayden Films 1.0 $10,000 screenwriting competition. So if you're a screenwriter wanting to submit your screenplay, definitely visit our film freeway and submit your film.
That link's down in the description below, and you'll get to really support independent screenwriters by checking out this contest. So back to TikTok in particular. So I know we've always been an early adopter on certain brands. Mm-hmm. In particular, I know we started our Twitter account early on in like 2006, 2007. And quite frankly, we rested on our laurels at that time because we had, you know, a different vision. We had Facebook, and then Twitter, we didn't really know how to operate it. And then so what happened was most recently with TikTok, we signed up for our TikTok in 2019 when we were out in San Diego at Comic-Con, and we really just were playing around with it. You know, we did like two or three videos, and then we just, again, we started going down that rabbit hole of not touching it, right. just letting it there. But most recently, since we've been, you know, all inside and mm-hmm. trying to bring value to some of our clients and some of their projects and whatnot, we said, let's take a deeper dive into TikTok. And one of the things that I've seen, just from my perspective, from an entrepreneur, a business owner, and a leader, and a coach, and an educator, and something like that, is that they're doing a great job telling sponsored stories
right.
in a very short period of time
mm-hmm.
with really high-level call to actions.
Exactly.
So what have you seen from these 60-second spots that are converting you into taking some sort of action specifically on products or services?
I think that the short minute-based content is really, it just draws in your attention right away. If you can strategize the perfect way to draw in your target audience, you kind of just have them right then and there. You know, people are then prompted to want to dive more into your brand.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's really the biggest aspect with this promotional aspect of TikTok. I think that that's the biggest thing is drawing people in right away.
So, I mean, what do you have to say about like certain categories of usage? I mean, obviously there's a lot of people that are making, you know, music-based content. Some mm-hmm. people are doing news-based content. Now you have more sponsor-based content and things of that nature. But what about the person who runs a small bakery, for example, you know, in their local town, and the owner of the bakery says, I just don't have time to work on another platform? How do small or medium-sized business owners really take advantage of having another platform? Do you have a personal perspective with all the research you've done?
I feel like if you are a smaller business looking to expand in the TikTok realm of content that's video-based, so picture a bakery. I think that to become more immersed in that kind of culture, you know, you one want to be, because the algorithm is going to show whoever is meant to see it, which is your target audience typically. Mm-hmm. But I think that as a bakery, you want to involve your audience by, you know, hey, today, this is how we're making this entree or mm-hmm. this cake, whatever the case may be, whatever you want to showcase and kind of develop your brand through that kind of content. I feel like it's really easy because, you know, it doesn't take that long.
Mm-hmm.
You don't really have to strategize that much when it comes to like writing. Mm-hmm. However, you want to like show your personality, you want to develop your brand in that sense. And I think that the algorithm does do a really good job.
Yeah, to that point, I think what I've noticed is that, especially if you're writing a social media plan specifically for your traditional media like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, I think what I'm noticing by consuming some more and more TikTok content is that it seems to be more authentic.
Exactly.
There seems to be less emphasis on everything being perfect. And mm-hmm. I think that's what's more attractive mm-hmm. to these types of stories and videos and such. So I personally, from a person who is looking at it from an agency perspective, but I'm also looking at it as a consumer. Like, for example, just a few months ago, I was watching a video, and that particular video had a new tool mm-hmm. that I thought was interesting. And I'm checking out this new tool in 60 seconds. I'm like, wow, that's a pretty cool tool.
Right.
And then I came back to the office later on. I saved it. Actually, I text messaged the link to myself.
Yeah.
I came back in front of my desktop. I checked out the tool. I said, wait a minute, this might be a new tool I didn't know about. Boom. I set up the tool and I was really impressed. And now we use the tool in our workflow. So mm-hmm. I just strongly recommend people to think outside of the box in terms of some of these new tools. I get it. You know, people are like, oh my gosh, I don't want to have another tool. However, you know, getting those consumer eyeballs on your brand mm-hmm. when this is consistently changing is so important. And then one last quick thing about the food, right? Obviously everyone loves food. I mean, we happen to have a client who is really interested in doing a lot of videos in right. his kitchen specifically. Walk us through, you know, I know you pitched him on eventually making more phone-based videos.
Yeah.
What's that process been like?
I feel like it could, I have a vision that, you know, you want to quickly say what you're doing, show clips of exactly the recipe, and then, you know, list what you're doing. I feel like it's a lot easier than we think. I mean, it takes a lot of playing around mm-hmm. with and, you know, understanding how to work with videos if you haven't done so before. Personally, before TikTok, I didn't really have that much experience, but
yeah.
I found that I adopted it
mm-hmm.
so quickly. And we can also see that in terms of like the amount of users of the app. I think it's over 800 million
yeah.
users internationally.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, when it comes down to strategizing how you're going to base your content around your brand, especially food, I think that, you know, recipes or just giving short ideas or tips on how to eat or what things to buy. And I feel like that's ultimately the best way to use the platform for that.
Yeah. I mean, one of the things that I've also noticed recently is that a lot of restaurant groups, especially with everything that's been going on the last 9 months, you know, a lot of restaurant groups that did not believe in the Uber Eats or the mm-hmm. DoorDashes and some of those things, they are now adopting short videos. I mean, I've seen this really great series of videos in New York for this one particular pizzeria. And he keeps making these really cool TikTok videos with the slices of pizza and
That's
the guy
awesome.
Comes out. And I'm like, man, when I'm in New York, I'm definitely going to that
right.
pizza shop. So I really encourage everyone that's watching our video today is that embrace these tools. I get it. You may personally not use the tools, but it's about consumer attention. So if you're looking really to get someone to learn about your product, your service, any types of affiliate linking or products that you're trying to sell or educational courses, it's very important for you to just to try it. You know, TikTok's not going to, you're not going to click a button that's going to, you know, jack up your brand, so to speak. You're going to be you're going to do well with it. Just test it out. Be familiar with the products. Because I think it's the same way if you look back at VHS Then we went to DVD. Now we're streaming.
Right.
It's the same concept with some of these tools. So any parting words on the TikTok concept?
Constantly evolve.
Yep.
And just continue to immerse yourself and be authentic and be fun with it. And just really embody your brand. And like you said, continue moving up and trying it out.
Yep. So if you want to check out all of our social media links and handles, check out the description below. Follow us, of course. Keep up with our Hayden Films Minutes by checking out all the links below and up top, of course, in the card. Until the next time, continue making a difference.